The incision that you see here will be closed with simple interrupted sutures. Grab the needle with the needle driver about 2/3 of the distance away from the tip. This avoids any damage to the tip of the needle or to the swage at the rear where the suture is fixed into the needle. Ensure that the plane of the needle is at a right angle to the plane of the needle driver. Remember, the passage of the needle through tissues is meant to follow its curvature. This is done by gentle supination and pronation movements at the wrist. Not following this curvature and tugging the needle across will lacerate the soft tissues and impair healing. Always insert as well as retrieve the needle from the soft tissues at a right angle. You can do this by either applying traction to the skin as is seen here, or counter pressure with the forceps on the opposite side. Rotate the needle along its curve through the tissues to minimize trauma. Pull the slack with your right middle finger and with your closed forceps if required. We'll be using an instrument tie for the knot. Lay the needle down and grab the long end of the suture in your left hand. Position the needle driver parallel to the incision within the V that has been created by the two ends of the suture. We'll be starting with a surgeon's knot. This is done by creating two loops of the suture around the needle driver, grabbing the short end and pulling it through while crossing the hands. This lays the half hitches flat against the tissues. Because we have crossed our hands, we now have a reversed V with the short end lying towards us. To complete the surgeon's knot, reposition the needle driver parallel to the incision once again within the V that is created by the suture. Create a single loop around the needle driver, reach over, grab the tip of the short end, and cross your hands once again to create a secure surgeon's knot. Pull the knot to one side of the incision so as to not impair healing. I'll now palm my needle driver in the right hand, pick up a pair of scissors, cut the suture, lay the scissors down, and continue with the suturing once again. A general rule of thumb is that the distance between the needle and the incision is the same as the depth of the needle pass. The adjacent suture should be taken at twice this distance away from the previous one. When knotting, remember that all the knots must lie on one side of the incision and not on the incision itself, which would impair healing. Also remember that we need approximation and not strangulation. Some laxity in the suture is needed to accommodate the edema that will surely ensue in the post-operative period. Broadly, there will be two types of incision that you will be needed to close. One will be straight with very well apposed edges, while the other might be elliptical. For proper closure, the length of the ellipse should be at least 3 times the maximum width. A higher ratio is always better for cosmesis. To close a long linear wound, it is often beneficial to start at the midpoint and progressively bisect the incision with sutures, as you see here. For the elliptical incision, starting in the middle would produce a suture under significant tension, which may not even be accurate. Therefore, we will start at one end of the incision. I will then move to the opposite end of the incision and keep alternating till I arrive at the center.